to have,
like if you read a book and the punctuation's correct, that works really well with a book.
Complex LFOs,
but when you're reading copy, there's a different kind of punctuation, and sometimes you have a half a beat somewhere, which if it was a piece of written word, you wouldn't put it there. But it just makes more sense when you're saying it.
So there was just this
it's all about the, you know, and the other thing is giving air, you know, it's like sometimes that piece of air between those two words makes those words really powerful.
Almost nothing up until almost
there's nothing worse than someone with copy that's just overwritten, and then they wonder why it doesn't have the emotion they were hoping for.
Or in actual fact, what it is,
you know, it's the old less is more theory. Had initially, you can make some amazing statements.
We do that sometimes.
Using very little words, but a ton of
knobs or features. The vintage knob was the same
like
word
you just did.
Yes, probably.
Okay. So, what is the one thing that most people don't know about voiceovers and voiceover actors?
Well, it's funny. Even people who do it, everyone's got their own skill base.
Like the, you know, the slop knob.
The smart ones, the ones who have a knob, you know,
all that really fun different knobs and all the different modules that you have.
I always work on the 80-20 rule of 20% talent, 80%.
Let's talk about that version knob, and let's go back.
You know, it takes into consideration everything from selling and marketing and all that kind of stuff.
First of all,
I think I don't know whether a lot of people, especially in this country, understand the relevance of studios. It hasn't really taken off. The way it has in the US.
Right, that's
which I find interesting.
You
know, I don't know quite why. There is a fear.
But sometimes they were just.
I think sometimes Australia,
like all the time.
You know, for some reason, is a fearful country. You know, people don't particularly like change.
Really?
The fear of what? Is it the perception that maybe because you're doing it at home?
My head off within minutes, so I never did.
It's amazing your brain isn't toasted then.
Yeah.
There's some good chemicals in that stuff.
Yeah, no kidding. Well, maybe it is.
Then I just beam into wherever. And in some cases, like a lot of my clients, I don't even talk to them.
Man who put together and owned Learjet, John Lear. And John has some unusual ideas about virtually everything, including UFOs. Including
Scout Voice Management,
Area 51,
and then I'm not signed to it. A lot of my clients are overseas. I look after myself, and I just channel News Asia out of Singapore. Radio station in Dubai called Dubai I. And then whatever else comes in, corporate narration stuff, whatever.